Have you ever been mocked at by somebody? Has somebody made you feel little or small? Have you ever been criticized for the work that you have done? Have people around you told you that you're no good or that you cannot achieve anything in life? Good evening and welcome to the Reach for the Stars learning series, week 3. And today's topic is building self-esteem. My name is Rinku, and today we will go through while we go through all these negative situations in life and so many external influences upon us, right? We will learn how to build our self-esteem and keep our self-confidence and believe in ourselves and learn to still reach for the stars, as I say, right? Okay, so yes, there have been situations in everyone's life, you know, where we have been mocked at, where we are criticized, where we feel little and where we feel small. But what happens, you know, when such things happen to you? How do you respond to those situations? What are the thoughts that are going around in your head? So let's look at the 6 things that you can do to build your self-esteem. Every time you feel crushed, every time you feel little, or every time that you feel small. Okay, so here goes. Here's tip number 1. Become self-aware of your self-talk. What is your inner voice telling you? Yeah, the inner voice that's going on in your head. Learn to become self-aware of your thoughts. You know, that niggly little, you know, the monkey mind chattering away and telling you, what is it exactly telling you? Is it telling you things that are negative? So is it telling you that you can never learn, you know, how to crunch numbers? Is it telling you that you can never paint well, that you cannot lose weight? What is it that it's telling you? Yeah, or that your parents will never appreciate you, you know, no matter what you do, that your teacher will never be happy with you. What are the thoughts which are running in your head? So tip number 1, become aware of your self-thoughts, yeah, of your self-talk. And start writing your thoughts down. Start writing it down. You have a little thoughts journal and start writing your thoughts down. Now, the first step is to listen to yourself. And if you really think that there's a lot of negative self-talk that's going on in your head, start challenging, you know, those thoughts. So if you said to yourself, oh, I can never, ever paint, yeah, start challenging yourself. And then, you know, change that thought and affirm it, you know, with a positive affirmation. Say, yeah, I mean, you know, I can always try to paint better. Yeah, instead of saying that, you know, I can never ever paint well. So yes, so the first thing is to look at your self-talk, keep a thoughts journal, start writing, you know, your thoughts down. And if there are negative thoughts, there's something that I do, you know, every time I have a negative thought in my head, and if I become aware of it, I immediately tell myself, you know, cancel. It's like writing, you know, your mind is like a blackboard. And we only want to have good imprints on it, right? We only want to have a good message. We want people to read, when they read our stories, we want them to read nice things about ourselves, right? We want to feel proud of who we are. So on the blackboard of your mind, whenever, you know, there is a negative thought, I say cancel, and I kind of erase it out. I visualize myself erasing that thought and, you know, affirming or, you know, writing another fresh positive thought on it. Yeah, so that's what I do, and I hope it helps you too. And yes, please do keep that thoughts journal. Write all your thoughts down for the first few days. I would say for about a week, just keep writing whatever thought comes into your mind. Yeah, and then in the second week, start changing those thoughts. Start learning to change those thoughts into positive sentences. Yeah, okay, so that's the first thing, learning to become aware of the self-talk in your head. listening to it, challenging the negative self-talk, and rewriting positive affirmations, right, on your blackboard, on the blackboard of your mind. The second thing is to avoid the compare-despair rabbit hole. Yeah, so tip number two, avoid the compare-despair rabbit hole. What do I mean by this? As human beings, we constantly are looking at others, right? We're looking at the student, you know, who gets the first rank in class. We're looking at the topmost performer at work. We're looking at somebody who can sing really well. We're looking at somebody who is, you know, maybe can do a lot of things, you know, a really talented person who can study well, work well, you know, sing well, dance well, does a lot of wonderful things. And no matter what they touch, you know, they have the Midas touch, everything turns into gold. And we're looking at them, you know, envying them and, you know, pitying ourselves. So that's something that, you know, we should not be indulging in. So avoid the compare despair rabbit hole. And at this point, I would like to share a story that made a difference to me while I was growing up and while I, you know, heard the story. And I hope it makes a difference to you too. So there was this Japanese farmer, you know, who had to walk every day to the pond, you know, to bring water in, you know, to his little farm and, you know, water his plants. He had a little vegetable garden in his home, and he had to walk to the pond every day and bring water for the vegetable farm, right? So he used to carry, you know, two pots with him all the way from his house to the pond. And one of those pots was cracked. There was a little crack, a little teeny weeny crack in one of those pots. So every day while the farmer filled both the pots with water and, you know, carried it all the way back, you know, to his home, to his vegetable, you know, farm to water them. One, the cracked pot used to feel really upset because all along the way, you know, from the pond to the farmer's home, there would be water seeping out of that little crack. Yeah, and he was very unhappy with himself because he said, I can't even, you know, manage to bring a whole pot of water back home from the pond. And every day, you know, he used to, you know, feel so upset with himself, right? And then the farmer, you know, one day he told the farmer, you know, I'm no good. Just shatter me and get yourself a new pot. You know, every day while you fill me up, you know, with so much love and care, you know, all that I do is, you know, throw water out on the way as you bring me back home. And I'm not doing you any good. I'm of no use to you. Yeah, I only managed to get back half a pot of water. And the farmer smiled at the crackpot and said, have you ever noticed your side of the path, you know, while we go back home from the pond? Have you noticed your side of the path? And the crackpot said, no, why? He said, I want you to notice the path on your side. Yeah, because the farmer carried both the pots, you know, on the two ends of a bamboo stick and held it on his shoulders. You know what? That's the way he carried the pots back home. So he said, please notice the path on your, you know, on your way, on your side of, you know, of the path. And the crackpot started, you know, looking at his side of the path as they walked from the pond, you know, to the home. And he was amazed to see that there was a whole row of beautiful flowers. You know, there was an entire flower bed all the way from the pond to the home, to the farmer's home. And then he looked at the other side and, you know, there was nothing there. There were no beautiful flowers. And then the farmer said, did you see your side of the path? And the crackpot said, yes, it's amazing. They're lovely, colorful flowers all the way from the pond, you know, back home. And he said, yes, you know, while you thought that you had a flaw and while you thought that you had a crack in yourself and that you were not being of service to me and you were not, you know, doing the job that you meant to be, but you were actually helping me. So I noticed the little crack in your pot. And what I did was to, you know, plant flower seeds. I planted, you know, the seeds of flowers all along your side. And every day as I walk from the pond back home, you have been watering those seeds. And you've been responsible for the growth of those lovely flowers. Isn't that a heartwarming story, my friends? Yes. So we are all cracked pots in some sense. Yeah. We all have some flaws, some cracks, but it is for us to look at the beauty in each one of us. It is for us to not compare ourselves, to not, you know, think about, not everyone is in their own time zone, you know, as we say, and everyone has their own path of progress. So yes, tip number two, avoid the compare despair rabbit hole. Never ever compare yourself to anybody and definitely don't despair. Yeah. Okay. So tip number three. Yeah. So are we all ready to look at tip number three? Tip number three is to channel the star within you. Yeah. I keep saying that we are all stars and we all have a lot of light within us. So channel the stars within you. Focus on your strengths. Focus on your strengths. Look at the past. Have you not had situations, you know, attempts, you know, things which you're good at? What was your proudest moment in life? When did you feel really happy? When, what is one thing that you would like to, you know, shout out to the world and celebrate and say it aloud and celebrate? So think of all those moments of celebration. What are all those happy moments in your life? Focus on your strengths, things that you can do well. Yeah. So while you might not be really great at studies, you don't really have to get the first rank in class, but you might be, you know, awesome in sports. You might be, you know, wonderful at badminton. You might be wonderful at table tennis. Yeah. You might be wonderful at dance. You might be a great singer. So what is your talent? What is your talent? What is your strength? Focus on your strengths and shine the light on your strengths. Yeah. So channel the star within. Focus on your strengths. That's tip number three. And yes, there are wonderful assessments out there, you know, to help you figure out your strengths, to find your strengths. And if you would like to get one of those, reach out to me and I will help you with that. Yeah. So focus on your strengths. That's tip number three. Channel the star within. Then tip number four is to really, you know, set goals for yourself. Now, what is the thing that is bothering you? Yeah. The negative self-talk that you're having, is there something that you can do about it? Is there something that you can work upon? Is it really true? Is it a fact or is it fiction? Yeah. Why are you beating yourself up? You know, why are you feeling low? Yeah. Now, instead of feeling low about it, yeah, set goals to work on it. So that's, you know, tip number four. Please set goals to work on everything that is breaking you down. Yeah. Is there something that you can do about it? Are there people around you that you can reach out for help? Is there a course that you can take to build your skills? What can you do, you know, to become better at it? Yeah. So set goals and start working on those things if they really mean a lot to you. Whether it is relationships that need working, whether it is building a certain technical skill, whether it is aiming to start a new business, a new enterprise, whatever it is, yeah, whatever it is, set those goals, write those goals down and start working on it. Look up for resources, look up for support groups, look up for supportive people around you and start working on those goals, right? And tip number five is to be of service to others. Every time that you feel down, have you noticed that when you help somebody out, when you, let's say you help an elderly person cross the road, you know, or a blind person cross the road, or you pick up a child, you know, who has fallen down and help them nurse their wounds or, you know, bandage their wounds. Don't you feel good about it? If you share your knowledge, you know, with other people, if you've helped somebody learn something new, if you've helped somebody, if you've helped your mother, you know, in the kitchen today, you know, if you've helped her prepare a meal, if you have helped your neighbor, you know, run an errand for them, maybe, you know, go grocery shopping for them. Yeah. So whatever it is, how do you feel when you be of service to others? It really lifts your spirit, isn't it? Yeah. So be of service in any way that you can. Be of service, whether it is physically moving around, being emotionally present, giving your time to hear somebody out, whatever it is, whatever you can do to be of service to somebody else. And you will see that when you make somebody else happy, it automatically lifts your spirits and builds your self-esteem. You feel good about yourself. You feel good about making a difference in somebody's life. You feel good about touching someone's life in however small a way it is. So be of service. And last but not the least, remember to love yourself. So self-love is very, very important. No matter what the situation is, get up, dress up, and show up. Yeah. So however you're feeling, do not ignore, you know, the way you look. Do not ignore, you know, get up, you know, wear a bright color, you know, put on some good clothes. Yeah. Groom yourself. In the pandemic times, you know, we really are not going out, but if you could, you know, go to a spa, you know, get a good haircut, you know, get a good massage. So love yourself. It's important. Make sure that you eat the right kind of food. Make sure you eat nutritious food. You know, drink, you know, 6 to 8 glasses of water minimum, you know, in a day. Make sure you're hydrated. Make sure, you know, you have 30 minutes of exercise in a day. And if you think that 30 minutes is too much, start, you know, with 10 minutes. Yeah. So make sure that you love yourself. Make sure that you take care of the physical body that you are in. Make sure you eat nourishing food, nutritious food, drink enough water, you know, exercise, every one of it, that it is important. It does lift your spirits and it does make you feel better, right? So yes, so here are, you know, all my tips to help you build your self-esteem. And I hope that you found this useful and that you will certainly, you know, pick up one of these tips, try it out, and start working on, you know, any of these tips. You know, pick any of it which works for you. I would say, you know, pick the self-talk first. Start working on the self-talk, because everything has to do with what you think of yourself. So everything begins with your thoughts. So start becoming aware, you know, of your self-thoughts, and start keeping a thoughts journal, as I call it, and start writing it down. And of course, you know, the other things, like I said, that was tip number one. Tip number two is to avoid the compare despair rabbit hole. And tip number three was to channel the star within you. Focus on your strengths. Tip number four was to be of service to others. And last but not the least, tip number five was, you know, to, there was one more. I asked you to set goals. Yes, set goals for yourself. You know, pick, you know, what you want to work on, and, you know, set goals for yourself. And tip number six is to be self-love, you know, make sure that you care for yourself and that you love yourself. It is important, and that you take good care of yourself. So thank you so much for hearing me today. And this is Rinku, and I hope you love this session on building self-esteem. This is just, if you'd like to learn more about, you know, how we can do this, we do run, you know, a 2-day program on helping you build your self-esteem and carving out a strong identity for yourself. Please do get in touch with me at grinku@gmail.com, or please feel free to subscribe and be a part of Nakshatra, our tribe, where and you can, you know, be a part of the exclusive tribe Nakshatra, where you get to learn, you know, these different topics every week. And you can be part of the exclusive tribe, where you get to network with other people, share their experiences, you know, share knowledge, and learn, grow, and reach for the stars, as I say. Thank you very much. See you again next week.